Hey everybody, this is Death by D4, and welcome to my guide on how to play as the Swarm Keeper Ranger subclass in Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition. There's a lot to go over, so be sure to subscribe and let's dive right on in. When you take this subclass at 3rd level, you get Gathered Swarm, which grants you an intangible swarm of nature spirits that become an integral part of your character, occupying the same space as you do, and disappearing only if you ever die. Once on each of your turns whenever you hit a creature with a weapon attack, you can then call upon your swarm to help you in a variety of different ways, including dealing an additional 1d6's worth of piercing damage to your target, forcing your target to succeed on a strength saving throw or moving them up to 15 feet away in any horizontal direction, or moving yourself 5 feet away much the same way. Alright, so, though this isn't necessarily what I would consider to be a very crazy feature overall, the added power and utility granted by this feature is actually pretty incredible. After all, not only can it boost your damage output, but it can also help you control the flow of battle by repositioning your enemies and yourself on the fly. And all of that works whether you're within melee reach or at range with your enemies. That is just absurd. Seriously, not only that, but there's no limit on the number of times that you can actually use this feature either, meaning that you're always going to have access to it whenever you need it. Seriously, just... wow! Definitely a super solid feature for you to get in general, and one that you're bound to get a lot of use out of over time. You also get Swarmkeeper Magic at 3rd level, which expands the number of spells available to you as a ranger. Best of all, these spells don't count towards your spell's known limit, meaning that you'll always have access to them whenever you need them. Of the selection made available to you, I'm going to give a special shout out to Magehand, Fairy Fire, and Web, as all of these are just awesome spells for you to have access to as a ranger. At 7th level, you get Writhing Tide, which allows you to use your bonus action to gain a flying speed of 10 feet with the ability to hover, ending after 1 minute or if you are ever incapacitated. You can use this feature a number of times equal to your proficiency bonus, recharging after a long rest. Wow, so I'm not gonna lie, but this is a pretty awesome feature for you to get in general. After all, despite how slow your flying speed actually is, the simple fact that you can use this feature as a bonus action allows you to very easily pair it alongside of another action. Not to mention the fact that you could use this feature multiple times a day, allowing you to very easily make regular use out of it over the course of a campaign. That and, if you do happen to be playing as a ranger who makes use of ranged attacks, then you can make great use of this feature during combat by flying over the heads of your enemies and raining death down upon them. Overall, an absolutely amazing feature for you to get, and one that you should take full advantage of once you get there. At 11th level, you get Mighty Swarm, which improves your gathered swarm in a variety of different ways, such as increasing your piercing damage dealt with it to a d8, causing creatures moved by your swarm to be knocked prone, and whenever your swarm moves you, you now gain half cover until the start of your next turn. Wow, talk about some solid improvements across the board. Now not only is your swarm even stronger, but the added utility that can provide to you is genuinely incredible, allowing you to either inhibit your enemies or hunker down and get some additional AC. All in all, another fantastic feature for you to get, and one you'll likely be glad that you have for later on. Finally, at 15th level, you get Swarming Dispersal, which allows you to use your reaction upon taking damage to grant yourself resistance to the damage taken, and teleport to an unoccupied space within 30 feet of you. You can use this feature a number of times equal to your proficiency bonus, recharging after a long rest. Okay, so, wow! This is absolutely an amazing defensive feature, allowing you to not only mitigate a crucial instance of damage that you take, but then reposition yourself to a more advantageous position, which can include a position up high in the air if you're already under the effects of your Writhing Tide feature. That is just insane. And to top it all off, you can also use this feature up to 6 times a day. Yes, you heard me, 6. Seriously, there are not a whole lot of defensive features like this that work like this, so if you ever find yourself in a difficult combat encounter, then make sure you take full advantage of this whenever possible. Definitely a super amazing feature for you to get, and one that makes for a pretty respectable capstone feature for this particular subclass. Alright, that does it for all the subclass features. Now on to just a few of my own personal recommendations concerning it. It should go without saying, but most of the subclass's abilities revolve around the use of your Gathered Swarm feature, meaning this subclass is going to be highly focused around combat in general. So if that doesn't sound like something that you're interested in, then you might as well play as something else. Now as for feats, Piercer is just an incredible feat for you to take overall, as not only does it help raise the amount of damage that you could deal with your Gathered Swarm feature, but it can also help you deal some pretty nasty critical hits too. That and, if you mismatch this with your weapon's damage typing, then you can even stack this with either Crusher or Slasher as well, allowing you to gain their benefits as well while also amplifying the brutality of your critical hits to new heights. Next, let's talk about spells. Now, out of all the spells that you consider taking for this subclass, I would highly recommend focusing on spells that trigger off of your weapon attacks. That way you can then trigger your Gathered Swarm feature and stack it with whatever effect imparted by your spell. There are a whole lot of spells that qualify for this, like Absorb Elements, Hail of Thorns, Hunter's Mark, Zephyr Strike, and etc. So as you level up, just be sure to keep an eye out for spells like these, as those will synergize just greatly with you and your subclass's features moving forward. Finally, let's talk about tactics. Now for those of you interested in ranged combat, I'd highly recommend making regular use out of your Writhing Tide feature in order to gain a powerful position over the battlefield. That and, though imparting the prone condition with your Gathered Swarm feature isn't all that helpful for you at a range, you could use this to help grant advantage to any of your allies nearby your target, or to help trap them inside one of your allies' AoE spells. And finally, for those of you interested in melee combat, just remember that inflicting the prone condition with your first attack can actually be beneficial to you, as that then grants you advantage on the next attack that you make on your turn before they have the chance to stand back up. That and if you happen to be playing as a tanky character playstyle at higher levels, always remember that you can grant yourself half cover as well, allowing you to feel that little bit safer when facing down your foes with that little extra 2 AC's worth of protection. And that's it! If you liked the video, then be sure to subscribe and let me know what you think down in the comments below. And if you'd like to have the chance to play D&D with me, then feel free to join my Discord server, and consider supporting me over on Patreon. Thank you all so much for watching, I'll see all of you in the next video.